I really didn't know a lot about radiation other than, you know, like x-rays.
I had no knowledge of what it was going to be like.
My fear was just the fear of unknown.
I didn't really know what to expect.
Radiation oncology is a crucial part of cancer therapy. Close to 60% of cancer patients will receive radiation therapy sometime during their illness. Many times, this is with curative intent. That is, our goal is to get rid of the cancer permanently. For patients who can't be cured, radiation therapy can relieve pain and other forms of suffering and greatly improve quality of life. This is a very effective, life-saving, and life-improving therapy. Radiation kills a cancer cell by damaging its DNA. The DNA is the genetic material, the blueprint of the cell, and by damaging that material, the cell can't divide, it can't grow, and the cancer dies. One of the most enormous advances during the last 10 to 15 years has been how accurately we can target radiation therapy. Radiation therapy involves typically multiple beams, at least two, often three, four, or even more beams, all of which come in from different angles, all of which hit the tumor. So the tumor sees all the beams, but the normal tissues only typically see one or maybe two beams. And by targeting these beams to within millimeter accuracy, we can destroy the tumor and leave the normal tissue almost unharmed. I think it's important to recognize that radiation therapy can cure many, many patients. We probably cure over 100,000 patients a year who have cancer, with radiation alone or by combining radiation with chemotherapy. Radiation therapy plays an important role in reducing pain or making symptoms improved in patients who can't be cured, but it's also a powerful curative way of treating patients.
Cancer is not a death sentence, in no way. Cancer is just something that happens in life, and you stand up and you fight it, and you have your friends and family and all the people you love stand with you and fight it.
This video is brought to you by the American Society for Radiation Oncology. For more information, go to www.rtanswers.org.